Good morning, Life Center family, and so many more out there. It is my honor and privilege to share my heart with you this morning. But before I do that, I just want to tell you personally that I miss every single one of you. The worship team and I cannot wait for the day when we all come back together and worship in the sanctuary, lifting up the name of Jesus. I think you're going to sing so loud with us that the roof is going to blow off the building. Just a thought. So I cannot wait for that day. Today, I'd like to share and bless you with a brand new song from our community called Spirit of Revival. Right before the beginning of 2020, the team and I had an amazing opportunity to go to New York City and lead worship at a massive event with Global Awakening. Many of you know them. And thousands of people came to worship with us. We didn't know them, they didn't know us. But when we worshiped together, the Spirit of God fell so strongly in fact, that the end of our worship set, at the end of it, nobody wanted to stop worshiping. We put our instruments down, we lifted our hands, and we joined the crowd in just corporately lifting the name of Jesus. It was an incredible, incredible moment. We were really inspired as a team, and we came home and a few of us wrote this song together called Spirit of Revival. It was originally called Great Awakening, but it's called Spirit of Revival. And it really, we were inspired by, this was a glimpse of what God is really doing and is going to continue doing all across our nation and the nations of this earth, no matter what is coming against us in this season. So we wrote this song, and some of my favorite lyrics of this song are in verse 3, where we sing, "There's a power that cannot be defeated. There's a name that brings the dead to life. Jesus Christ, the hope of every nation. He is here and he's breaking every chain. He's with you today. He is our hope, the hope of our hearts, the hope of our families, the hope of this nation and the nations of the earth. In him, nothing is impossible." John 16:33 says, "I have said these things to you that in me you may have peace. In this world you may have tribulation." You will have tribulation, it actually says. "But take heart." I love that. Be encouraged. Take heart. "For I have overcome the world." We see this phrase in the Bible again, "take heart," in Psalms 31:24. It says, "Be strong and take heart, all who hope in the Lord." That's you this morning. You who hope in the Lord. So my prayer for you today, as you hear and listen to this song, that you would turn it up in your car, that you would turn it up in your household, that you would have an encounter with this God of hope, that his Spirit would overwhelm you. He would fill your heart, fill your home, fill you right where you are, and that faith would rise up in you to believe that he truly has a plan, that his promises are yes and amen for your life. This situation that we're in, no matter the trial, no matter the tribulation, he has a plan and he finishes it. He's an amazing God. So as you listen to this song, we pray that you would join us in declaring these lyrics and that you would see a change in the atmosphere, in your heart, in your home, wherever you are this morning, that hope would arise with you. We bless you.
From the ashes, there's a song waiting to be sung. From the heart of every generation, we want to see a great awakening. There's a light piercing through the darkness. There's a love setting prisoners free. His holy fire is moving now among us. We're gonna see the grace.
this our prayer tonight.